We live in the society of the great deal. And President Trump, I want to offer you my good friend President Trump, right? My good friend President Trump, who's got outrageous love in his heart, and he loves beauty, and he loves, right, outrageousness, right? And he loves, right, power, and he wants to do good for the American people, right? He wants to. He desperately wants to. And so we're going to actually love you open, President Trump, and appreciate all that's good and wonderful and beautiful. And with your permission, humbly, I want to offer you a teaching, right? Right? Because we can all offer each other teachings. I've learned so much from you. So you wrote a book called The Art of the Deal. See, here's the problem with The Art of the Deal, my friend. The problem with The Art of the Deal is when you make a deal, you're always trying to make a great deal. And in a great deal, what's a great deal? A great deal means, wow, you got the most and you gave the least. You know, and in the second debate, when you were asked about whether you paid contractors, you kind of said, well, I didn't always pay the contractors because I was being a good businessman. So I get that. You're so brilliant in so many ways I couldn't even touch. But can I humbly offer you this? Here's the art of the deal. In a real deal, an outrageous love deal, you don't get the most and give the least. You both give outrageously. There's an ethic of generosity. And when I hear you talk, President Trump, I feel the generosity. I feel your goodness. I feel your integrity. I feel your beauty. And by the way, I'm furious with everybody demonizing you, right? Blank that. We've had enough of that, right? We want you to succeed and we are outrageously loving you. And the art of the deal is the art of outrageous love. You give the most and you receive the most. And giving and receiving, there is no distinction between them whatsoever. That's the art of the outrageous love deal. And friends, let me, in these couple of minutes, let me tell you a story. And then, Barbara, you're going to take us after the story, if you can. Beloved, give